Well, meat, the more I think about it, this place could be a really good addition to the Strip. A vault-themed hotel and casino in an actual vault, a functioning vault. I mean, the house hasn't let it be a casino, but we could easily set it back up as one, add a fourth casino to the Strip, be a new source of income. And, being as I'm pretty close to the lady that runs it, I'm sure she'd give me a pretty hefty cut, especially if I were to sink a lot of caps into the place to get it up and running, and use my business acumen to get it off the ground. And, if we were to excavate all the parts of the vault that house sealed with casino, with concrete, rather, we could, we could keep using, like, the top level for hotel and casino, and the lower levels, we could keep a hardened military base down there for emergencies, and maybe a personal emergency panic room for me and my nearest and dearest, like you, me, just in case anything bad happens in the future. But yeah, having a fully functional vault around is certainly nothing to sneeze at. So yeah, definitely think we should keep working on this place, and working on Sarah, if you know what I mean. So, let's get back to it. Meat, stop sitting down all the time.
Come on. I always imagined
there you go.
Be a terrible place.
All right, where is this lady anyways? Oh, there she is.
Hey, stranger. Where you been, huh? I missed you.
Of course you did.
You're kicking me into gear, huh?
Sure am.
Well, I think I'll...
Let's go. Let's do this thing. Oh, and she trusts me enough to consider leaving the vault to visit her brother. Oh, let's go have sex first, then we'll deal with that. Having sex is always a good idea. And to break the fourth wall for a moment, I went ahead and installed a mod for some additional map markers, mostly along the Strip and a few in Freeside also, so we don't have to hoof it everywhere all the time. Gets annoying. Basically puts a map marker for every casino, this place, the station, the embassy, then in Freeside, the King's HQ, the Atomic Wrangler, and Mick and Ralph's all get their own, which is really nice, because you either have to go to the Strip North Gate every time, or go to, like, the outside gates and then go in. Which is always silly.
Well, well, if...
Alright, let's go back upstairs and then wait a couple hours and she's back up there, because... She seems to get buggy if you try talking to her down here.
It's really nice in here. Way better than I imagined a vault could be.
Yeah, I told you. Alright. Wait like 3 hours, or wait, not that long. 2 hours. Alright, where's you at, Miss Sarah? I'd have to wait until morning. Alright.
Evening.
There she is. Playing with her Pip-Boy.
Stranger, where you
hear the noises.
I missed you. All right. It's almost impossible for me to step out of here. But Sheldon, I... Okay, I suppose you're right.
I'm always right. Are you blindfolded? All right. Well, let's go.
And interested in taking me out for a drink in one of the casinos? That might be fun.
Drinks are always fun, darling. She's messing up my third-person camera. Alright, so her brother is the man known as Michelangelo, who apparently designs all of the neon signs for Vegas. Though his real name is apparently Sheldon, but he goes by Michelangelo. Guess that sounds more impressive. Here he is.
Oh, hello, I am Michelangelo. How can I... wait. Are you here to deliver more billboard requests? Please tell me you're not a messenger on behalf of Mr. House.
I'm not a messenger on behalf of Mr. House.
Because spending myself to the edge of artistic oblivion for Mr. House sums up my existence since I had to leave Vault 21. That's why. Most people don't understand what it means to grow up in a vault.
I grew up in a vault.
Its corridors, its walls radiate a warmth that feels safe, honest.
No, I never really felt like that, personally.
Huge and threatening. It's so empty that I think one of these days I'll just snap. I feel haunted by something terrible. Working in such a huge workshop often makes me shiver. I can't even leave the strip. Yes, I think so. But please, keep quiet about it. Without inspiration, I'm as good as a tumbleweed drifting in the barren wasteland. Ah, an educated fellow.
Yes. Vault educated.
Exactly. How can you help me regain my inspiration? Thank you for the offer, but I think I really can't go to see... Wait a minute. I know, I don't have to necessarily be there to see it. Yes, yes, that's it. I have a camera. It is old, but it should work. Perhaps you could bring me images of inspiring landmarks.
I suppose I could do that.
I've always wanted
for the brother of my new lady.
And its thermometer sign at Novak. Then there's the famous Bison Steve sign.
Those are easy enough.
Airfield and the Helios 1 power station signs are
Karen's easy. Helios, I've never actually been to or that place, but I do have need to go to them eventually. Alright.
Thank you. I really can't thank you enough for this. Please, get me all the pictures. I'll compensate you accordingly. Oh, and if you need more camera film, then just come back and I'll get it for you. Again, thank you.
Why the hell am I frame suffering so much when I talk to you?
Aha! The brave photographer returns. Good to see you. My sister and I... Thank you. That's great. Really great. I really can't thank you enough for this.
Well, well.
Alright, I guess I need to bring you back. Oh, you're gonna go unblindfolded now, huh? Okay, darling, let's go. Oops. We don't want to be stuck in there. How do I get out of this place? Yeah, through the non-functioning... Oh, okay. There we go. Alright, look at that. Sky and everything. You should probably not just stand there playing with your Pip-Boy. Come on, dummy. There you go. Alright, it's just, you know, right across the way.
Thank you so much. You're an angel. I can't wait to see Sheldon again. Hey, stranger. Well, sure. Thank you. You're an angel.
Yeah, I'm pretty awesome.
Really? Well, sure. My pleasure. Oh, that makes me so happy. You are too much. My good.
Alright, I guess that's it for now. Alright. We'll come back tomorrow for some more loving with her. For now, I'm gonna see about doing some other work here on the strip. Oh, where'd you guys come from? And I think I'm gonna start in the tops. I do remember Swank telling me a while ago that the their little entertainment club was looking for new acts. Yes, it is. Yes, I am.
You did it!
Oh.
You killed Kaisar!
Look, even Willow wants to talk about it.
You're a hero! I'm so proud of you!
A hero? I've never really been called a hero before. I mean, I guess I have, but I'm still not real comfortable with it. They did call me a hero when I brought water to the capital wastes, but I don't know. I think of myself as a pirate and a ne'er-do-well. Alright, so this... Yeah. So this is the Aces Theater. Apparently the coolest entertainment review in New Vegas. And apparently they have the Rad Pack. Who's this guy? He looks pretty cool. No, he's just a gambler. Alright, who are you?
Hey, hey, welcome, welcome.
Oh, a fellow pirate.
Entertainment experience in New Vegas. My name is Tommy Torini, and how can I make your day?
With caps?
Well, it was my idea. Well, me and the rest of the Rat Pack boys. We took it to Benny, and he thought it was a good idea. A few years later, here we are. The best show in New Vegas. Well, apart from serving as a talent manager, show schedule, and all-around man in charge of this fine theater, I happen to be its headline act.
Every night, you're sure you're come on pretty by, full of yourself, aren't you? Pack
review live, only right here at the Aces Theater.
Oh boy.
Well, acts are a bit thin on the ground right now, but every night from 8 to midnight, we got the Rad Pack Review. Songs, dancing, jokes, we got it all. Sure, baby, sure. Tommy's always looking for new talent to bring to the Aces. Tell you what, you see any good acts while you're out wandering? Give him my card. If they work out, I'll give you a 3% cut of the door.
Cool.
Just swing back by as you recruit folks. I'll get you your bread.
I hope by bread you mean caps. But, yeah, let's make it 5%. Because no one shortchanges Solomon. Alright. Well, let's see what we can find out here. Actually, I've got somebody in mind already. Lonesome Drifter guy. Let's see if he's still standing by the side of the road north of Novak. Yeah, that's about the right spot. That's the guy.
Howdy there, partner.
Your friend.
Maybe it's time to give these tired old bones a rest.
Hey, do what you want with your bones. Just keep me out of it.
I suppose it's only right you get a little something for your troubles. Here, my daddy left me this gun. Guess I don't need it no more.
Sweet. The mysterious Magnum. Let's check that out. Yeah, I'm the mysterious stranger now. It's a pretty nice looking gun, though. It's got some nice engraving on it. It's not probably as cool as my lucky pistol, but it's pretty cool. Got some hand loads in it. Does it both ways, eh? Alright, I might play with that for a bit. Alright, well, we'll head on back. Tops.
That's the guy who killed Caesar.
Yes, I am. Man, I am famous all of a sudden. Should have killed Caesar a long time ago.
Well, well, well. If it ain't the best love cat on the strip in my theater, what could Tommy do for you,
man? I'm not the best love cat on the strip yet, but I will be.
Cowboy act, yeah. He dropped on in here not too long before you. He's got chops, baby, real chops. And I ain't just talking about that mustache. And
cool.
Like we agreed, here's your fee. 5% of the cut comes to 166 caps. Don't spend them all in one place now, unless it's right here.
Sounds good.
You know it, baby.
How's it hanging?
Pretty low. Alright, let's get back out there. This might be, I don't know, let's see. Seems like part of my talent is close at hand. Who are you?
Hey, come on, pal. I'm trying to put on a show here. You're welcome.
Okay.
All right, then make it snappy, kid. This isn't exactly a lucrative career enterprise here.
I can tell.
The name's Knight. Billy Knight. And this here's what a lifelong career in comedy will get you. Oi.
So, not very far.
That's exactly my point, kid. Exactly my point!
Don't yell at me.
If you believe my mother since she first laid eyes on me. First thing she said was, boy, that's a funny looking kid.
Yeah.
I guess I got a face only a mother could love, because no one else would give me the time of day. Hey, maybe you can help me. See, I can never tell when it's lunchtime.
Is that supposed to be a joke?
Breaks better than a shot. Less chance of lead poisoning. Hey, if you know any gigs hiring, I'll work cheap. Real cheap. I'll take peanuts. I'll take the shells!
Okay.
Yeah? Hey, you're all right. Tell him I'll do it for 100 a night. No, 50. No, 20. 10.
Hey.
Don't rob me, I'll do it.
I get paid from what you get paid, so don't sell yourself short there, pal.
Whoa, jeez, what was I thinking? You're right. I gotta go in there with a cool head, tell them how much I'm really worth.
Not much, but, hello. You know. You don't have to tell him that. Let's go right on back. Hey, look at this. They added the names to the billboard. Got the Rad Pack Review and Billy Knight, the King of Zing. Oh wait, the Rad Pack Song and Dance Review, okay, 6 p.m. Got Billy Knight, the King of Zing at 4 p.m., the Lonesome Drifter at 10 p.m.
Aren't we?
Yeah. Let's go get paid. Over the caps.
Well, well, well. If it ain't... That comedian, you mean? Yeah. He was a hell of a haggler. Cost me a pretty cap. Hope he's worth it. Here's your 5%.
I don't really care if he's worth it or not. I got my 5%. But hey, something different's better than the same good thing all the time. Gotta mix it up or people get bored of the Rad Pack. Alright, let's wait till tomorrow. And go see my lady again before we head out to find the next two pieces of talent. Maybe I could snap a few of Michelangelo's pictures while I'm out there. Or I don't know, maybe I should wait till I have Sarah with me to do that. If she ever gets out of the vault. There she is.
Hey, stranger. Your room is ready, and in the meantime...
Now, let's have sex with her first, and then go recruit the other talent. And we'll take her to the show. That way she can see a real good show. Looks like it might bug out again. My companions didn't follow me. Sweet. Vault 21 pre-war holotape. What is that? What does that do for me? And it's worth a lot of money. That's what. Yep. There you go. Yeah, get in bed, let's do this. Oh yeah, baby. Relationship trust.
That was something else.
Damn right it was. So this is my place now, huh? Not a lot to it, but I've got a pre-war hot plate. There's the gang. Alright, let's go recruit these other two tool bags. And we'll take the lady to a show. Weren't you guys just downstairs? We already had a fast travel marker here, but I guess now we have another one. Yep. Two right on top of each other. Well, whatever. Alright, so it seems like one of my jerks is in the Atomic Wrangler. So we'll use my brand new quest marker, or map marker for that, and get right on over there. Look at that. That is handy. I'm gonna guess it's this ghoul up on stage. Hadrian the Ghoul.
Whoa, baby. Am I looking at a mirror? Or are you just that ugly?
Oh-ho. You're a funny guy.
Whoa, Nelly. There's insult comedy, and then there's psycho comedy. I guess you aren't the heckler Garrett hired to spice up my show. What do you want? Either you need to get your eyes checked, or that fame is fleeting thing is true. And since I happen to be world famous, you must be going blind.
World famous, huh?
Bet you never saw a ghoul in a suit before.
Actually, I've seen a lot of ghouls in suits. Killed a few of them, too. Me as the worldly type. You would be incorrect about that.
Yeesh, is my act that bad? Or are you just that dumb? Yeah, that's right. Got me a nice juicy contract with the management.
Juicy, huh?
Okay, I admit it. I ain't exactly rowing in caps here, but what do you want? I'm under contract. I can't get out. Too bad I got this ironclad contract with the Garretts. They'll never let me out of it.
No, sure they will. I'm friends with them.
Good luck. Garrett's a tough, mean son of a bitch. He's not likely to give up. Let me know if you make any headway.
I've made Garrett a lot of money, and got him that fucking disgusting sex robot that he wanted so much. You.
Doesn't look good. This buildup of...
Shut up.
Now why would I want to do that? His performances make me quite a lot of money.
Yeah, I got you that fucking sex robot, you creep.
You have been a useful associate, that I'll grant you. Okay, he's yours for a discount. Just make sure the stage is downwind of the audience.
Another NCR, of course.
Any luck with Garrett? Really? You mean I'm finally out of this shithole? That's great. Thank you.
Yeah, now get out of here, you bum.
Hey, bud. What's up?
Have you seen the new Securitron upgrades? I pity anyone who gets testy with those bots now.
Ben, you're drunk. Go home. Let's get out of here. We're going to Novak, apparently. Or hopefully it's not raining. Yeah, I think I should wait. I'm not going to take a picture of the dinosaur right now. Yeah, look at that, I got a special marker for the Novak player room. That's not where I'm going, though. Actually, where am I going? Move it! Come on, meat! Oh, Jesus Christ. Let's see... Going right here, I guess.
Our rangers are going to show everyone what happens when we're
nice place you got here with a motorcycle gas tank and a pot in the middle of the room.
Oh, please don't kill me. I swear I'll have...
Wait, what now?
You don't work for Mr. Bishop, do you?
I don't yet. Does he pay well?
Sorry, it's just... You look like his type, you know? You got that hard-ass wasteland explorer thing going on.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, you do look kind of familiar. It's been a while since I was in New Reno, but...
Oh, so you have heard of me. Yeah, that's right. I was the big draw at the Shark Club. People used to pay hundreds of caps to see me.
I don't think I ever paid hundreds of caps to see anybody sing, but whatever, pal.
You don't know Mr. Bishop. He's not like other bosses up there. He knows the wasteland like the back of his hand, and he likes to wander it. I knew if I didn't get way the hell away from New Reno, he'd run me down like a dog. Oh, well, that's all just a big misunderstanding, see? Mr. Bishop, well, he owed me a lot of money, and, you know, he's a busy guy, so I sort of figured I'd just take it off his hands. Robbed is such an ugly word. It's more like I took care of a payroll problem for him.
Yes.
Also, I might have, sort of plowed his daughter. A little.
A little? Wow, you, sir, are a cool dude.
But if Bishop finds me and I don't have his money, my balls are going to be on his trophy wall. Really? The tops, huh? Well, it's no shark club, but I hear security on the strip is real tight. Even
sure is.
Wouldn't hit a joint like that.
Not if he didn't want to answer to me.
Thanks.
Alright, I guess that's all, you jerks. Anything else I should be doing while I'm out here? Don't stand so close to me, Sid. You know, I should, while I'm out here, let me hit up, Camp McCarran. I, never did turn in Motorhead's helmet. Who was I supposed to turn that into? Shu? Yeah, Shu, I think. And a map marker over by the front of this place would be pretty useful. Right around these doors. But no such luck. Yeah, let's go see Shu. What's up, Shu?
You're not too long ago. I'm told you're the one who got him out of the vault.
I'm Skippy.
Can't tell you how relieved I am. Sending him on that mission was a mistake. That's probably true, but I wonder if I should have taken a different strategy entirely. Although my options were certainly limited, with most of our forces tied up garrisoning this place. Regardless, what you did for Anders isn't something he or any of us around here take lightly. We're all glad to have him back. Thank you. Unbelievable. That man has given us so much grief since we set up here. This may be a major turning point for us. I can't tell you how many times we thought we'd taken him out. Only to have him show up again later, taking more heads off of fallen troopers.
Yeah, you fucking people are incompetent. He wasn't even hard.
And this is from a pool me and a lot of the soldiers around the base had going. You may not be NCR, but hey, it's only fair.
Yeah, how much? 300. I'll take it. Alright, back to Vegas. To the tops. Followers are considered anarchist revolutionaries. Sure, I'm glad I joined them. What's up, my man Swank?
That's the guy who killed Caesar.
Yes, yes I am. That's gonna get old eventually, though. I'm gonna have to do something else to make me famous.
Hey, hey,
what's up,
welcome,
One Eye?
Welcome, welcome to the finest entertainment experience. You talking about Mr. Isaac? Damn, baby, when you bring them in, you bring them in. That cat's gonna bring me money like you wouldn't believe.
Sweet.
Here's your 5%, baby. you enjoy that.
Oh, I will. How much cash? 250?
That ugly mug with the razor tongue? Dig it, baby. He'll be one hell of a novelty act, just like Tommy promised. Here's your 5%.
Another 210 from him. All right. All in a day's work. Everyone, what happens when we're pissed off? Is that Billy Knight tool? The Drifter? The ugly, yeah, they're all here. Cool. Well then, guess it's time to take in a shit with my lady. One of my many ladies. Let's see, I wonder who she'd like to see. Let's check the schedule. I'm thinking Isaac, he seems to be the most famous of the bunch. He goes on at 8. Lonesome Drifter at 10. Hadrian at 1 p.m. He's definitely the bottom of the barrel, apparently. Well, he's a ghoul, so, you know, they're gross and all. 10:25. Alright, so we're gonna have to wait till tomorrow.
Hey, asshole!
Hi.
Everyone loves a good insult, am I right? So you'll love Hadrian live at the Aces Theater.
Will I? Thank you for calling me a fucktard telepathically. Great. Alright. 16 hours or so. That should find her here, and then I can recruit her and or whatever. Tell her I want to take her to a show, and then we'll wait some more. Hey, baby.
Hey, Strange. I hadn't thought about that. Well, I mean, yeah, good times. Let's do it.
Okay. Alright, stay close to Daddy now. See, ain't it pretty out here? That big blue sky and everything. Alright, so the show starts at 8. So 5 hours. Actually, let's do that. I go in.
That's the guy who killed Caesar.
Yeah, I've heard that a few times. It's 7:55. Yeah, looks like the Drifter's up there right now. Oh, come on, guys, let's have a seat. Watch the show. I don't know why the Drifter's up there, actually. He shouldn't be.
You'd be crazy to put your money on either side of the coming battle.
I agree. You put your money on me. Where the hell is Sarah?
I've heard that your trons are nastier than ever.
She's over there.
That's the guy who killed Caesar.
You're damn right it is.
I hope Swank's
hey,
smarter
your mama,
than
what's
Benny.
The haps? I thought Benny was a stand-up guy.
I don't know. They must have the times messed up or something. Whatever. We saw the Lonesome Drifter. Great show, wasn't it? Wait a minute. Where is she?
Well, well. If it...
Stand up, lady. Oh, that's cool. Alright, we'll be back in a moment. Alright, so we fixed it. We've gone to see the show at the Tops, and now I'm ready to escort Miss Sarah back to her vault.
That's the guy who killed Caesar.
Come on, let's have some fun.
We just did. We saw a show. Alright, you want to jump in the fountain? Fine. We'll jump in the fountain. Just for you, Willow. Just so you know, I'm not ignoring you, because I have another lady. A couple other ladies, really, but, you know, whatever. Come on. There you go. I just jumped in the fountain.
You did it! Hi there, handsome.
You don't actually care. You just said it, now you don't even want to do it. Typical woman.
Hey.
Alright, there we go. Escorted Sarah back.
Hey, stranger. Silly, but that'll be our secret, okay?
Okay. I think that means we're going to have sex. Not entirely sure. And then we can talk to her about going to see the neighbors. Yep, means we're gonna have sex. Unfortunately, she's not here, so we're gonna have to do this again. All right, come on, Miss Lady. There you are. Get into bed. I ogle your butt. And I'm gonna do other things with your butt. Dirty, terrible, secret things. That's what's making those noises.
That was something else. I look forward to the next.
I am a monster. What can I say? All sorts of weird little things out here. Got a Dinky the dinosaur with the motel sign. That's pretty cool. Does intercom work? No. None of this shit works, apparently. Got cool posters. Gone. There's my friends. Move it, meat. Yeah, alright. What time is it? 3 a.m.? Wait a couple hours for her to come back up into the shop.
Hey, Strange. Well, yeah, sure. I thought I'd never see New Vegas. Well, I mean, the Strip. And Freeside.
Alright, let's
go. I do, but, well, please don't get lost, okay?
Me get lost? I don't think so. Alright, come on. We're gonna go play. And what are we gonna do? I guess, let's see. Actually, yeah, we'll hit the old Ultralux. I actually don't even know if I've been in here yet. Oh dear. Okay, we'll be back in a minute. Alright, I know what you think. This doesn't look like the Ultralux. It's not. I've decided I'm going to go first before I continue working on the families on the Strip. Go see what this Colonel Moore wants of me. And to do that, I need to go to the Hoover Dam, someplace else I have not yet been. Now I had to leave Sarah back there. She's not brave enough to leave the Strip or Freeside yet, so we'll pick her back up when we go back. Alright. Get ready. No, not yet. But soon, momentarily, you're going to get your first majestic view of the Hoover Dam. There she is. Look at that. That is the Hoover Dam, kids. And Willow's scatting back there. So when I see the Hoover Dam, all I think about is scatting. That is a big piece of artillery they get there. Hey, come on, give me a map marker. There you go. Alright, let's head inside. That looks like a snow globe. Sure is. Hoover Dam. Alright. Alright, let's see. This way. Hey, fellers. Yeah, so this is what a hydroelectric plant looks like. Dramatic music, dramatic music. Ma'am?
Made it. I've been receiving reports about the savior of the end for a while now. And
yeah, that's funny.
Myself. You've proven yourself especially capable.
That's true.
And right now, I can use all the capable people I can get.
Crocker gets I bet you can. Most of you are incompetent.
When people need something really important done, they come to me.
Full of ourselves, aren't we?
More rangers to see these things through, but I'm a little short-handed at the moment. Think you're up for a real mission?
I'm better than anybody you got.
Since the majority of my men are on assignment dealing with the Legion, I need someone to handle other matters that have arisen. Make
despite
no mistake,
the fact that I've like single-handedly crippled the Legion.
Loose ends when the time comes. One such loose end is a gang known as the Great Khans. Have you heard of them?
Heard of them. I've already taken care of them.
Good riddance. We've had reports for years that they're the ones who supply the fiends with chems, but no one's done anything about it. In any event, no one will miss them. And I've got another mission for you. We've had some disturbing reports recently concerning the Omertas, one of the three families that run the Strip. Our intelligence has discovered that high-ranking members of the Omertas have been having clandestine meetings for the past several
clandestine.
Months. We haven't been able to determine whom they've been meeting with, but if it's Caesar's men, we'll need to act. I need you to uncover what they're up to and stop it if it threatens the NCR. Any questions?
Nope. I was about to hit up these fuckers, the Omertas, myself.
Head to their casino, Gamora, and ask around. If
maybe I'll do that first instead of the Ultralux.
The NCR, stop it. The Omertas themselves likely won't be forthcoming, so you may need to talk to some of their help to pick up a trail. Anything else? Our preliminary research shows that the Omertas used to do some business in Freeside, mostly buying weapons. Any other questions? Liza O'Malley at the embassy may have some information for you as well. Dismissed.
Not a soldier, you don't dismiss me, lady. I come and go as I please. You'll do well to remember that. Now then. What's in Freeside North Gate? What we need to do is hit the Strip Embassy. Michelangelo's, because I have the map marker for that. Actually, I should have gone to the vault.
Seeing the sights?
But whatever, it's close enough. Yes, yes, I am seeing the sights. You got a problem with that? Alright, where's my little lady friend? There she is.
Hey, stranger. Well, I do.
All right, to the embassy.
Hello.
Hello. You're Liza O'Malley.
Welcome to the NCR Embassy. How can I help you? Ah, excellent. I received word you may be coming.
I'm always ready to come.
With some thugs that were taking advantage of her. She owes us a favor. Go talk to her. She'll be able to point you in the right direction.
Okay.
Sir?
I already knew to talk to the hostess or whatever. We'll fast travel down to the Lucky 38. Right over to Gamora.
Hey,
No one but Omeritas are allowed to carry guns to Gamora.
Fuck
Take
you.
Take the weapons with me. You'll get these back on your way out.
You, receptionist.
Hello and welcome to Gamora. What can I help you with today?
Oh, you're a ginger. You must have no soul.
I knew someone would call in that mark soon. What do you want to know? All I can tell you is to find Cacino. He's the lowest
Cacino, level
you're going to be able to talk to. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like. Ask him about it.
All right, will do.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. What the fuck do you want?
Oh, that's not very nice.
Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear. Because
I'm always fucking crystal, my man.
I don't give half a dick what you heard. Now get the fuck out of my face before I burn you.
Oh, what about
ass.
A quarter dick? Oh. Rude. Check his person, huh? Alright. Give me that. Now, maybe you're gonna sing a more friendly tune. A couple months of Cacino's activities, detailed ledger, many of his business deals, including the sales of chems and weapons. Here a quick glance at these transactions are his own personal finances, and this is done behind the backs of the O'Farrata family management structure. About many sexual encounters.
You again? What the fuck do you want? Where the fuck did you get that? Okay, listen, buddy. That's some dangerous shit you got there. That book can get me killed if the wrong people see it. Let's talk. What do you want? What can I do for you?
Yeah, some cash.
Okay, you got me by the balls.
Yeah, the short and curlies.
Maybe that'll buy you friendship.
It might, to start.
I can pay you for it, of course. I also have some information about the family's business that you might find interesting. Between you and I, we can break up what they're planning, maybe save some lives. Mine included, of course.
Then you would work for me when I take this place over, correct? When I replace Mr. House, if you were the new head man around here?
Oh, here's some caps. Now give me the journal. Right, there we go. So let me tell you what I know about the family's business. The bosses, Big Sal and Nero, have been working for
Big
a while.
Big Sal and Nero.
They're arming themselves like an army, using this new guy, Troik. They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as. I got no fucking idea. They let him have the run of the place, though. He seems like a nice guy, but he makes me nervous. He's a little arrogant, but he's too nice. Too open. I've never seen him fucking or gambling. Everyone has a vice, but this guy seems like the Pope.
Yeah, never trust a guy without a vice.
Okay, toss him at me. He's a skittish little fucker. Spends half the day pumping his body full of chems and the other half pumping hookers with his willy.
Sounds like an alright guy to me.
So he's able to smuggle huge shipments of weapons into the strip. The bosses got him by the short hairs. He covered up a hooker he killed while flying on some psycho.
Well, that's not good.
In exchange for not ratting.
Killing hookers is not cool. Hookers are people, my friend. Talented people. Alright, well, let's check around for these douchebags. Apparently they gave this Clandon, or Crandon, whatever the fuck his name was, guy is sweet. So he must be up here somewhere. What was his name? Clandon? I don't know. Some fucking stupid thing.
There's some serious shit going on between NCR and the Legion. They better not fuck with our power.
Power. Where is this shithole? Up here? This must be the guy. Oh, nice, I got a stripper pole in the room with a teddy bear and some psycho.
Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something?
Clandon.
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
Well, that's informative.
I'm a close friend of some of the family around here. I do some independent contracting around the casino, and they set me up with this great room. Cachino. Yeah, I've heard the name. Not sure why he'd send you to me. Is he helping out with room service or something?
You are an arrogant prick. Yeah, well, let's poke around. Books, cigarettes, empty suitcase, empty desk, Gamora bed. What's down here? A sink and a fridge. Nothing back there. You're trapping me, Sarah. Nothing over there. Nothing in that suitcase or desk. Let's see. Oh, what's that? A safe, eh? Alright, stop looking at me, asshole. Ooh, snuff tapes. This guy's been making snuff film up here. You're supposed to get a basement apartment for making snuff films, buddy. Now, let's see, these tapes contain horrific sounds of murder and violence. You hear Clandon engaging in violent sex with women, then hear the sounds of visceral and violent murder being carried out. Fantastic.
Good to see you again. Hope you're winning some money in here. I think I should kill you before you have a chance to show those tapes to anyone. What do I have to lose?
No, not much, but what do you get to gain? Leave Vegas, never come back, and give me 200 caps.
All right, give me 200 and I'll leave. I'm going a long way away from Vegas, but you better hope that you and I never see each other again.
I should probably kill this guy. He's dangerous. Eh, yeah, get him. Give me that, give me those. Cool. Done and done. And nobody seems the wiser. Despite the rather loud gunshots that were going off. What's this? Huh. Must be where he makes his snuff. Alright, let's see if we can find anything else on this level. Hmm. A dead prostitute. Doesn't sound like a guy strung out. Interesting.
I hear the Legion is moving some new tough muscle into the area.
Alright, let's find this Troika fella. Appears to be him right here.
Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave me alone.
I don't see how that's your business. I'm just a guest here, having a little fun.
I like fun.
Cacino? Cacino what? Are you kidding me? He must be trying to get me killed. Yeah? Well, fuck that. The bosses have my number and I'm a company man while they got the goods on me. Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel like any other night. I took some Kims with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood. I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me. You never know when you might find some trouble. That night, mostly buff out. I like to cut it with a little bit of jet and wash it down with some whiskey.
Good man.
That was my standard Saturday night. What? Yeah, you're right. I wonder what was up with that. When I saw the body, I started screaming. In a few seconds, some of their soldiers were in there cleaning up the room. They offered to keep silent about what happened if I agreed to help them get their hands on large quantities of guns at deep discounts. You'd do that for me? I'm not sure what can be done, but you'd be doing me a solid if you would. I've been talking to Big Saul mostly.
All right, I'll try to do you a solid, fella.
There's some serious shit going on between NCR and the Legion. Stay the fuck away from here.
Okay, sorry, man. Settle down. Big Sal himself.
Hey, you're Cacino's friend. You got business with me?
Yeah, I got business with you.
Sorry, but I don't know you from Adam. And you don't have any business getting in our business.
You should clear your throat, buddy.
Ah, Trike. What you want? Some more jet? A fresh batch of girls? Maybe a guy or two this time.
Maybe. I don't know.
What, that he's a murdering jethead? Not a new story around here. Yeah, I see where you're coming from. Okay, tell Troik he can hit the rope.
Will do.
We run a hotel. What do you think our business is?
I don't know, something about running guns and whatnot. Alright, so let's go back and tell Troik that he's out of his contract.
There's some serious shit going on between NCR and...
Shut up.
You again. Make it quick. Holy shit. Really? Okay, I'll help you. But I'm getting the hell out of here first chance I get. They're keeping them in a little utility section down off the basement.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what they're arming themselves for, but I know it isn't for the good of mankind. I'm pretty proud of myself. It's a stroke of genius if I could be so modest. The whole arrangement starts with an old buddy of mine in the Republic. He's responsible for packing and shipping supplies to the NCR on the Strip. He marks some containers as food and medical and packs them with guns and other shit. From there, it took just a couple of greased palms to get someone to let me cherry pick a container or two out of every shipment. Easy as pie. As a little pet project, I've been making some thermite. Thermite burns as hot as the devil's asshole. And can
How hot does the devil's asshole burn?
I've been keeping it so if the family betrays me, I can hopefully do some damage before I end up dead or in jail. Okay. Here's the thermite and a key to the room where the guns are stored. Place the thermite on the crates in the room.
Man, you idiots gave a fucking strung-out junkie the key to the room that the guns are sold in and then let him out of his contract? You're stupid.
As soon as we're done talking, I'm gonna make myself like a ghost. I don't want to be anywhere near here when the bosses find out. Thermite is a mix of rust and aluminum dust. If you add a little heat, a massive amount of heat is spit out. It gives off enough heat to melt through just about anything. It should make short work of the weapons.
All right. Guess this is the place. He said he rigged it to the light switch to go off, but I guess I need to plant the shit first. What do we got in here? Speaking of weapons. Guess that's all of it. Better get all my companions out of here. Probably don't want them to be in there when the thermite goes off. Everybody out. Let's close that door. Woohoo, boy! Whee! Yeah, that worked pretty good. It's all a bunch of fucking slag now. Alright, let's go talk to our man Cacino.
Big tough ranger, better not start any trouble in here.
Cacino, let's talk.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Hey.
Oh, is that so? Well, I can't say that I'm sad to see that fucker gone. Now. It's time for the meeting with the bosses. We can't chit-chat right now.
Yeah. All right. Guess we're going. I meant to tell him about the guns, but whatever. Alright, well, I guess we gotta kill these guys. Let's pick our poison. We got some more interesting weapons besides our holdout ones, but let's give the old mysterious Magnum a try. I don't want any guards seeing us going healed. Not yet. Is that a sawed-off? Yeah.
Stay the fuck away from here.
Sawed-off shotgun. Hand on the pump.
Stay the fuck away from here.
Shut up.
Hey, here's that gun I promised you. I suggest using it while they are talking.
Let's have some
words. I'm pretty sure they're gonna kill you after they
talk. Take a seat on the couch so we can get to talking.
Okay.
So I assume you know why we called you here. Yeah, Clan will be hard to replace, but not impossible. We'll find contractors just like them, without breaking a sweat.
Yeah, why don't you tell me about your plan?
Are you shitting me? You didn't even know what the plan was. Yeah, as a last request...
Did someone cut out your tongue or something?
Caesar asked us to provide a distraction on this trip.
So you're working for Caesar, huh?
All out assault on this trip.
First, now, Caesar's dead, so...
Then we're gonna use soldiers to kill every last motherfucker on the strip. Then we'll run this joint.
Yeah, I don't think so.
That'll teach not at home what can go on while he sits in his fucking ivory tower lording down from on high.
Yeah, fuck not at home too, but I'm your new boss. Well, I'm the new boss. Not really your boss, because you're about to be dead. But, yeah, why don't I turn you against each other first?
The fuck? I knew there had to be someone higher up helping you. Nero, you backstabbing, two-timing motherfucker. I knew this day would come.
You've got a dirty mouth. Bye-bye, Sal.
Nice clip there.
Thanks. Let's see what Big Sal's got for me. His password, his office key. He might even take his clothes. What about your friend, Nero? Alright.
Hey, thanks for all the hard work back there. I'm gonna run a tight ship here, don't you worry.
Yeah, you're gonna run a tight ship for me. Remember that. When I take out House, you're my man on the inside of this place. This family works for me now.
Of course. After all you did for me, here are some chips for you. Play, have some fun.
50.
Bye.
Cheapskate. Alright, well, let's see what we got here. Yes, he is. Soon. Don't need that. Anymore. Well, too late. Okay. Now, yeah. Guess that's that for this place. Now the Ultralux.
Those Legion elite troops are bad blood.
So, now I've got the Tops and the Gamora in my pocket. Two casinos down, one to go.
It's exactly like I imagined it would. Drunks?
Ready to tap your toes and snap your fingers? Don't miss Bruce Isaac, live at the Ace Theater.
Who the hell are you?
A velvety-voiced cool cat fresh out of New Reno. That's who. When Bruce sings, his smoky, dulcet tones will transport you to another world.
Okay.
It's perfect.
It is perfect, Willow. And it's ours. Or will be, soon enough. Better. This guy, he looks different.
Things are getting stranger.
Walter
Howdy,
Fietz.
Friend. How can I help you? But make it quick. Goddamn heat's worse in this town than in the middle of a Brahmin herd at noon.
All right, you're a articulate fellow, aren't you?
Sharp eyes on you, all right. We've gone through a heap of trouble to get in town. Ethel says I just need to wet my throat. A drink? Nonsense. All I need now is to settle a score. We didn't come a long ways just to stroll our best clothes around.
Ain't nothing wrong with having a drink.
If he ain't chiseling behind your back, he just sends his men ready for a fight. Then you either sell your ranch for a penny, or you're dead. I'm tired of being trampled over, kid, and I got a good mind to stop Heck once and for all. What more you want? He's a slithering snake, what he is. One of the biggest landowners this side of the Colorado, and it's all stolen, I tell you. All that money buys him any NCR senators he wants. Scoundrels like Heck. There's just no way for us small folks to get by, much less prosper, kid. We are honest folk out there. Damn hard to make the living in the desert, kid. Heck's a different breed. Goddamn thief he is. Scaring us into giving away our lands is all he's done to strike it flush. Comes packing iron and none can hold a candle to his men. Bad blood. I have no illusions that he'll ever stop his plundering, so I'm just going to make him suffer. That's what
I can't really hate somebody that town, plunders too much.
Our men to protect him. I just got to find out what he's up to, and then I'll know where to hit him hard. All right. Where I come from, we appreciate good intentions. I reckon you could help me figure out what he's doing in town. Tell you what, that chiseler's blowing hot air over at that there fancy casino, the Ultra Lux. Find out what's his story here, will you?
Every day.
You're his wife, eh?
If you don't mind, I have to look after my husband.
Yeah, I can tell.
He's got his reasons, and when that man gets a notion stuck in his head, he's like a bighorn or bull that's seen red. And if it means Heck Gunderson's involved, then you better step aside before the stampede tramples you over.
Okay.
If that's what you want to talk about, go see Walter. He'll talk your ear off. Everything he says about the evils of Heck Gunderson is true, but I've never held the notion that fighting evil with evil carries the world forward. I don't suppose you have the magic powers necessary to bring
his senses. I'm a pretty talented guy. A silver
he
tongue.
He won't leave this godforsaken city until he's seen Heck suffer. So far as I can see, we're the only ones in pain. That's very kind of you. Maybe this'll be the dawn of a new day.
Maybe so.
Howdy. Good seeing you again. I hear you. What's on your mind? Kid, look around you. There's poison and death everywhere.
Poison. I don't know about the death.
Misery we suffer. What right do they have to continue with their mischief and killing, huh? Hell, a good thrashing is what I want to give them. But I see your point, kid. Things will never change without us good folks. All right. I'm going to get Ethel far away from this damn city and head back home. There's a worthy life waiting for us there.
Yeah, good.
Thanks for your help, kid. So long.
Get out of here. I don't need any hothead do-gooders around here. Now, finally, to the Ultralux.
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons?
Okay.
My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience.
Yeah, you guys are creepy.
You have my assurance that everything will be returned upon your departure.
Little bit of Venetian angst going on up in here.
Waving their weapons around in the hotel. It's not the atmosphere we wish to cultivate. Please, enjoy your stay. They'll be handled with the utmost security in our bank.
Okay. Let's see, what do we got going on up in here?
So I hear the honcho of one of them strip families up and disappeared.
Oh, this is that Heck Gunderson fella.
I'm looking for someone. You ain't seen a young man with dark brown hair and a white hat on lately, have you?
I have not.
Ain't nobody got one darn piece of news about my boy. Not one lousy speck of information. Ain't got one Brahmin unaccounted for across a dozen ranches. But I'm here for an hour, and my own son just up and disappears on me. My boy, Ted, he was right here. I didn't leave him but a minute. I told him to stay put while I talked some things over with the White Glove folks. He was never one to stay tied down to a spot, though. Gets that from his mother. Got most of my staff out looking for him now. I'd be out myself, but I keep hoping he'll show up back here. Of course, if he does that, I'll whoop him till his skinny hide turns to leather for putting me through this. But that don't mean I wouldn't be grateful.
Yeah, I could help if you're a rich Brahmin tycoon.
I'd be more than happy to have you. Heck, I'll hire anybody with a pair of legs and at least one good eye at this point. There'd be a lot of money in it for you if you can get him back to me safe.
Mm-hmm. Now you're speaking my language.
You can bet I'll pay for the names of the sons of bitches responsible.
Cool, so I win either way.
Should have bet we'd kill the fiend's leader.
All right, let's see here. Yeah, this place is creepy. Are you the guy in charge? You got a top hat, so I'm gonna assume you are.
My, such a popular question. I suppose it is only natural to see us and wonder what it is that makes us special.
That pedophile mustache you have.
Society has only just made itself known to the public, of course, but our pedigree was established over generations. Were we always so refined? I'd be lying if I said yes. But I've always felt we were destined for a place atop modern society. And now, here we are. Not everyone can wear the finest clothes and eat the finest foods, obviously. That's just the reality we live in.
You are one weird
dude.
But
surely we can agree that the most tasteful, sophisticated people are the most deserving. And that's what the White Glove Society is all about.
I see.
No, not from the likes of you, I'm afraid. I don't think you'd have the stomach for it. Better look elsewhere.
So you gave me nothing useful. I need to find Marjorie. Let's see. In here. This must be the restaurant. You're Marjorie.
Welcome to the Ultralux. I do hope it exceeds your every expectation.
Oh, I concur.
I do, but one can hardly call it work. I think of myself as a caretaker rather than a common laborer. I suppose it is a labor of love if it can be called labor at all. We at the White Glove Society are all responsible for maintaining the beauty and class of the Ultralux. And as its founder, I suppose it falls to me to decide how we go about it. This again? I thought this was all settled. I answered every one of that investigator's questions to his satisfaction and gave all the help I could.
Did you give him a hand job?
I know our reputation hasn't always been spotless, but that's all in the past now. How some people can't get over it is beyond me. For the last time, the White Glove Society has never and will never consume human flesh for any reason. It's written in the charter.
What?
Now, didn't I already tell you that we don't do that sort of thing? We do not engage in cannibalism here under any circumstances. Though we haven't always been the White Glove Society. There was another time, a dark time.
So you used to be cannibals, and then you changed your name, and now say you don't, you've never done it.
Evolved past such
cute
impulses since settling into our new
nice
home.
Technicality.
I've seen to it that those days are behind us.
All right, let's see what else.
There was an investigator who came through here last week. He'd been hired by a young man whose bride-to-be went missing during their stay here.
Jesus, how many people are disappearing here?
You can only guess what probably happened, can't you? It seems perfectly likely that she got cold feet and ran off. And that young groom just didn't have a clue, the poor dear. A man? Well, then this... Well, this can't be. Two disappearances in my hotel? What will people say? I'm going to have a word with my staff about security on the premises. Whether these people are found or not, our guests simply must feel safe in their own rooms. Why, yes, I think so, if he hasn't checked out yet, that is. I had our maitre d' Mortimer offer him a complimentary room for as long as it took for him to be satisfied. You see, the White Glove Society remains the very picture of courtesy. Even in the face of such impolite accusations, we have nothing to hide here.
Maybe you don't, but maybe some other people here do. All right, let's talk to Mortimer again.
Good day.
You're not actually wearing white gloves.
How may I be of service, sir? Ah, yes. I've heard that one, too. Jealous people say such nasty things. I feel sorry for them. I can assure you that the only thing the White Glove Society is guilty of is preparing the tastiest cuisine you'll ever sample. That is, of course, if you can afford it.
Oh.
Private investigator. Ah, yes, I remember the gentleman. This was about the missing bride. Such an awful thing. I do hope he finds her whereabouts.
Probably in your stomach, creep.
Try, have you found something that will help his investigation? You are. Nothing so grim as his investigation, I hope. Now, ordinarily, we don't give out guest information, but I think, given the circumstances, he'll want to speak with you. Let's see. He hasn't checked out yet. If you head back to the hotel rooms, his will be one floor directly above you after you exit the lobby. I hope we can put this whole matter to rest at last.
Let's go find this investigator. Attacked. Well, this is a good opportunity to pick up some white glove clothes. The other one went all the way down here, huh? Give me your shit, punk. Alright, now, before I was so rudely interrupted. Crusoe, eh? Wearing sunglasses, and he's got red hair, huh? Well, I don't have a one-liner prepared, unfortunately. I will rip his sunglasses off, though. And a matchbook. Steam room, 4 p.m. Hmm. No, he's either got a date with a pool boy or he's meeting an informant. So, let's check out. Steam room, which is apparently through here, in the bathhouse. We can go for a swim. Neat. Sid, your body's disappearing. Let's get out of here. This is the steam room, apparently, but it's only 9 a.m. Alright. 3, 7, 6. Well, Sarah, what do you think about all this adventuring stuff? Indeed. What do you get for a gun there? A 10 mil? 10 mil. Is this our man?
Who are you?
Who are you?
You don't know? Oh, good. That's good. So they didn't send you after me. Where's the gentleman I'm supposed to meet? Oh my goodness me. They must know he was talking to someone on the inside. They'll be watching
every place
now. I knew this was a mistake. Mortimer, if he realizes it was me the investigator was planning to meet, he'll have me killed. Yes, the White Glove Society strictly forbids eating humans, but we weren't always the White Glove Society. Mortimer and some of the others have regressed to the old ways. They've taken many people over the last few months, but always from Freeside or secluded places where they wouldn't be missed. It wasn't enough. Lately, they've gone for tours.
Never enough.
Trip, even in the hotel.
Wants you to taste for long pork.
Of a cannibal becoming a gourmet. It's hard to please a refined palate.
Indeed.
The girl, the one who disappeared. I know what happened to her. Because I distracted her fiancé while they took her. Well, I'm not proud of it, but I had to. They could see I was having second thoughts. Some of the White Gloves began meeting privately a while back. Started talking about how we'd lost our identity. I started attending because I thought it was about changing our politics. Then they started talking about returning to the old ways, and there was no way out. They'd kill me for the things I heard them say. He's alive, as far as I know. I'm trying to keep him fresh. Mortimer has special plans for him.
Keep him fresh.
Banquet every night at 7.
That's disturbing.
Mortimer wants to reintroduce humans into our cuisine. Since eating people is a crime we punish by death, he's going to do it in secret. After everyone has eaten it, he'll tell them. With no real way to punish everyone, in Mortimer's mind anyway, their minds will be open to the idea of eating people as a delicacy. They might. But to him, the legacy of returning to the old ways is worth his own life. I don't think he expects it, though. I don't either. Nothing is more important to the society than being on the cutting edge of New Vegas cuisine. Mortimer's idea will appeal to that need. He just has to get them over the taboo. I don't know exactly. I wasn't in on it. I think some of them have stopped trusting me. But you can bet they're keeping him near the gourmand. Our chef, Philippe, has an obsession with fresh ingredients. It'd be back in the members-only section, so you'll have to be careful. Don't be seen, and more importantly, don't let them see Ted in the open. It's guarded both at the lobby entrance and in the access tunnels leading from the main restaurant. I could sponsor you as an honorary member. The White Gloves are always looking for people who can elevate their status. You'd certainly fit the bill with everything you've done around here.
Yeah, I'm pretty awesome.
Otherwise, we'll have to find some way to get inside quietly. It won't be easy, and it'll be harder still to get them out.
Well, they'll all be sampling pre-war wines before the meal. Maybe it's as simple as drugging them. Although, that wouldn't stop any future kidnappings. You'd have to expose Mortimer, but he's going to confess anyway. What if his revelation were a lie? What if no one had eaten human flesh but him? If you could somehow replace Philippe in the kitchen and serve a convincing substitute instead, you could walk Ted right through the middle of that room after Mortimer speaks, and then he'd have some explaining to do. Philippe has been trying to approximate the taste of human flesh for years. He must have a recipe somewhere.
Thanks for all the info, man. I think you've just done the whole plan for me. Good job.
That may be true, but I wouldn't recommend it. He's built a reputation, and it isn't for calmness and impartiality. He's not what he looks like. They call him Hurricane Heck. The man built his empire by hiring mercenaries to drive off the competition. Lately, he's been attacking our Brahmin suppliers so he can take over their business. He's the sort to pound in a nail with a wrecking ball. If you give him the whole story on this, he'd be liable to raise the entire hotel. And God knows what he'd do to the rest of the strip.
Let's plan on meeting again as soon as... Wait, did you hear something? Were you following?
Not to my knowledge. But apparently I was. Hey. There you go. Thanks, Meat. Alright. Well then. Where's this go? Hey, nice butt, lady.
Should have bet we killed the fiend's leader.
Casino floor. Okay, so if I can't get him to sponsor me, probably not going to get Mortimer to sponsor me. Let's see if I can get Marjorie to sponsor me.
Welcome to the Ultralux. I do hope it exceeds. Why, yes, of course. The White Glove Society is the most exclusive club in all of New Vegas. Perhaps the entire world. It's
perhaps
only natural that you'd need a sponsor from within the club who can vouch for your good name. Originally, we didn't allow anyone else in, you see. Founding members only. We thought exclusivity would make us the envy of everyone who's anyone. And it has. But then I had the idea to allow honorary members. Lower in status, naturally, but it just makes people want to be us even more. And the right people could certainly do wonders for our image. Celebrities, philanthropists, we want only the very best. And you most certainly fit the bill. Given your deeds on the strip alone, I can safely say that you would be a prized addition to our...
Fame is its own reward.
You have my full support, and you are welcome to join us at our nightly banquets in our special section of the Gourmand. I hope to see you there.
Well, I guess I should put on this formal wear. Take off my other stuff. Oh yeah, who's a spiffy looking dude now? Or perhaps I should put on the white glove attire. There we go.
I've heard that Securitrons are
now I'm a real creep. All right, well, let's, let's see, that goes to the kitchen. Apparently this arrow over here will go to wherever. Right. So it is telling me to go through there. Seemingly. Where's the other arrow point to? Casino floor. Ultralux kitchen. Let's go to the casino floor. There might be a way to the private area that way. Bathhouse, penthouse, suite. Members only section across the way. Into the kitchen we go.
You, what do you think you're doing? Curse it all. Your timing couldn't be more atrocious. Just make it quick, all right?
Okay. 449, let's see. This is Monsieur Philippe. Close that door.
Why are you standing still? Do you think the world waits for you while you stand there drooling? Get back out there and get to work. Who the fuck do you think I am? I'm the fucking god of New Vegas Brahmin fusion cuisine, that's who.
Oh, wow.
No, that doesn't even give me the credit I deserve. I fucking invented edible food.
Are you, taking psycho?
Good. You owe me your entire goddamn garbage existence. Oh, really? So despite your filthy face and your vacant expression and your complete lack of human dignity, you're telling me you're not a server?
Yeah, no, I'm not a server. Asshole.
Well, what do you want? I'm very busy here. What kind of harebrained fucking psychobabble bullshit is that? I yell at people because I like yelling at people, and because they fucking deserve it, not because Mumsy and Daddykins didn't hug me enough.
No, it definitely sounds like you didn't get hugged enough. Sorry.
Oh, I see how it is. You think because my father walked out on us when I was 5, now I have to yell at people.
Yes.
Or because my mother is a deranged chem fiend who regularly brought strange men home who told me to call them uncle.
And I bet they touched you, didn't they?
Shipping crate when they didn't want me around. And my brother... God, I'd forgotten about that. How could they do that to me? I can't stay here. I need to be alone. Forget about the fucking banquet. You know what? You can do it. You be the star chef. Take my recipes.
Okay.
Don't fill the hole, though. Just remember that. You'll always feel empty.
Okay, go cry. Okay, let's see here. Alright, take this white glove stuff off. Maybe just put on the formal wear. Now then, let's do a little cooking. Let's see, I don't even need his recipes. I'll do it myself. Imitation de tout à la viande bizarre. Cool. I'm gonna wait till 7, I think, because that's when the party starts. Lots of stuff in here. That guard still patrolling. Philippe's just chilling in here, eh? Let's close his door, if he has a door. You don't have a door, do you? Okay. Alright, nobody really seems to be patrolling anymore, so that's good. What time is it? 6:30. Another half an hour. Nope, nothing interesting in any of this joint.
How may I assist? At once.
Good man. Take the damn food.
The sooner you find yourself elsewhere, the better.
Get out of here. I'm stuck. Oof. There you go, champ. Get up there with that food. Three words. Oh, wait, no, there's four. Thanks.
My daddy's gonna kill all you bastards once he finds out what you done to me. My daddy sent you? God damn it. I almost died in here. What the hell took you so long? It's just one damn hotel. Who did this to me anyway? They hit me over the head before I got a look at them.
You're ugly.
All right, fine. I'm right behind you.
All right, let's do a little hard save. I remember this being... I mean, this could be difficult. Gotta be sneaky, sneaky. Alright, nobody's really looking that way. Okay, come on. Do-do-do. Let's do this.
I know I'm not the scheduled speaker, but I have a few words, if I may. There was a time, not so long ago, when we were bound together not as members, but as family, as a clan. And when Mr. House came to us with his proposal, we accepted, knowing we stood to gain much. Little did we know how much we'd lose in the process. As a society, we've endeavored to sample the finest food and drink the world has to offer.
Yeah, that didn't work. Okay, let's yeah, let's try this, actually. Load back to here. And I'm gonna have all the companions wait back in the other room. Except for Sarah. I don't think I can make her wait. Come on. Let's go, game. There we go. Alright, Ted's with me, right? Yeah. Sneak, dummy. Not very good at sneaking, are you? Alright.
Well, well, if...
Can I tell you to wait here?
Okay. The strip and free side, I...
No, she's still following me. Okay. You, wait here.
What's up?
Wait. And wait.
I'll see.
Okay, now, let's try this again.
I know I'm not the scheduled speaker, but I have a few words, if I may. There was a time, not so long ago, when we were bound together not as members, but as family, as a clan. And when Mr. House came to us with his proposal, we accepted, knowing we stood to gain much. Little did we know how much we'd lose in the process.
What did you lose, Mortimer?
We've endeavored to sample the finest food and drink the world has to offer, but we are living a lie. There is a meat sweeter than the most corn-fed livestock. Most of you have tasted it. All of you have coveted it. Among us, it is a crime to discuss a return to the old ways that unified our people. Tonight, that all changes. The taboo ends. Let me finish, Marjorie. You don't know it yet, but you are all now guilty of a greater crime. One that ordinarily bears the harshest of punishments. Surely that you are all guilty warrants not only universal amnesty, but also a renewed discussion. For our society to be truly elite, we must dine on the most delicious, the most exclusive food.
You are a weird cat.
And tonight, for the first time as a society, you are sampling that very dish, the meat we are forbidden to taste, the way it was meant to be eaten. Fellow members of the White Glove Society, bon appetit.
What did I do wrong? God damn it. Alright, we're gonna try this again, but I won't make you watch through the whole thing. Alright. So, Mortimer just finished his speech. We're going to try this again. I also had to turn Sarah's AI off, and hopefully that will stop her from attacking and slaughtering the whole room. So, let's try this again.
What the? Who is...
Yeah, no one's eating anybody, buddy.
What are you... Why is he there? Who are we eating right now?
I don't know, some Brahmin.
So be it. But we are all cannibals here. My death will be a constant reminder, and someday you will all remember.
Oh, come on, you guys gonna help me fight him or what?
Fortunate, and in front of all these people, too. He always was a bit of a pill, Mortimer. He was so pouty when I decided to ban eating people. And now this. I should have paid more attention to the warning signs.
Yes, pouting is always
Can
a good warning sign.
Can you imagine what people would have said? Why, it would have been a complete scandal if it weren't for you.
Yeah, I'm pretty good. Now that means you're going to support me, right?
Ta-ta.
Yep, I'm idolized.
How do you fare?
How do you fare? Ooh, I want your top hat. Hey, give me that. Give me all that stuff, too. What are you people doing? You don't even know, do you?
Salutations.
Well, well, if it is... Greetings.
Alright, we gotta turn her AI back on. Oops. Out of here. What are you doing, buddy? You don't even know, do you? Alright, you follow me.
Hey.
Let's get going.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, that's everybody, right? Pretty sure. Well, let's go take Ted to his daddy. Which is here? Yeah. Alright, come on, Ted. Where the hell is Ted?
We've shown everyone that these are our new territories.
He went there on his own? I don't know. Maybe he's stuck back there somewhere? Hmm. Alright, where'd the dummy get off to?
Caesar's fate was sealed from the start.
I'm stuck. Let me out. Let me out.
Did you know this trip's all stirred up?
Alright, there's Ted. Now, come on, boy. Gotta get you to your pappy. Put your damn fist down, you moron.
God, Ted, are you all right?
Quit your hollering. I'm fine.
You got me my boy back. I got no words. Now, I hope you didn't do no harm to whoever's responsible for this. I want to skin their hides myself.
Let's see, I wonder what the best option here is.
Confound it. I just don't know how I'm supposed to sleep, knowing whoever done this got away. All right. Well, I promised you I'd make it worth your while. So here you are. Try not to lose it all at the same casino.
Hmm. And now the strip as a whole idolizes me. Well, my work is done. I have successfully recruited the entire strip to my cause. Now let's get the hell out of this creep show. Alright, let's bring Sarah back to her vault. Actually, I'll just I'll let her take herself back to the vault because I'm gonna head to I'll just take her back to the vault. we're gonna call it an episode here. It's a little sexy time.
The strip and freeside, I love it, but people are weird around here.
Sure are.
My vault? Yeah, sure, if you like. Okay, see you soon.
Alright. Now let's go have a little bit of sex and call it a day.
Legion elite troops are bad blood.
Hello, lady. Let's do this thing. Brick-a-chicka-wow-wow. Alright, guys. Well, we're going to call that an episode. I will leave y'all with the sweet sounds of the Fallout fade to black orgasm noises. And I will see you guys next time.